Hello students, very good morning to all of you. Today in this lecture we are going to discuss a unit about writing given to us in our text. Writing refers to creative writing, things like email writing, notice writing, report writing, etc. In this writing section, we are going to discuss a topic that is report writing, or we call reporting an event. Let us first understand what report writing is all about and why is it important. Report writing is reporting an event that has happened across the world or anywhere, or something that you have seen. You give an overview of the event that has taken place. What is the purpose of report writing? The purpose of report writing is to give larger number of people or a mass information about the same. What we know as reporters do, journalists do, as we see on the television. It is to inform wider audience about it with reality, with facts which they do not know, and acknowledge them with necessary information. This allows the audience, the listeners, the knowledge gainers as to what has happened, and to understand, analyze, assess the situation, what actually the event was, and to appreciate the importance and to bring success. Therefore, report writing, or the learning of report writing, becomes very important for us. Well, we are going to discuss the important aspects of report writing in this lecture. For that, there are certain things to be kept in mind, which I will discuss with you. Since a report writing is written after the event has occurred, isn't it? Something that has happened, and now we are reporting that event. Therefore, the past tense should be used. This is one important thing, and the first and foremost thing to be kept in mind, that the event has already taken place. Now we are reporting it. Therefore, past tense is inevitable. We must report in the past tense. Our language should be such, our speech or writing should be such, which is of the past. Second important thing to note, keep the report short. If it is too lengthy, the listeners or the readers become bored. Therefore, a report should be short, clear, to the point, what do you want to express in your report writing, so that it does not confuse anyone or confuse the readers or lose their interest or attention. Third thing that one needs to keep in mind, try to include the main points in the first paragraph. It means right in the beginning. Only then you will capture the interest of the person. As you see many a times about advertisements or on the YouTube videos, the thumbnails are so catchy that you happen to click that. So they force you, they induce you to click it. So in that way, the first paragraph should have all the important events or important points regarding your report writing, which gives a gist, a kind of boost to the reader of what the event is all about, an overview of the whole event. The fourth important point, organize the details in a logical manner, a manner that someone can understand. It is logically understood by a reader or a listener, and present them in paragraphs, one after the other. It should be in a very organized and a well sequenced manner. The next and the fifth point, provide interesting information to hold the interest of the reader. The information that you have laid or inserted in your report writing should be very, very informative and interesting. It shouldn't make the reader bore, otherwise he will lose interest in that. The sixth important point is, end the report by mentioning whether the event was unsuccessful, successful, and what impact it had on the attendees or what happened in the event. So these are the few points while writing a report should be kept in mind. Now let's understand what is the format of report writing. What are the points which are important while you frame a report when an event has already happened? Let's see necessary parts of it. Format of a report writing. The format of a report writing or an event that has taken place. We will take the first thing that is very important is the title. So whenever we write anything, definitely we have the title, a story, an essay, an email writing, we have the subject. So title is very important. Now to have a word about this, the title should be short, very, very impressive, eye-catchy, and relevant to the topic. If the title is something that grasps interest to the readers, only then and only then will a reader continue to read the report or the other things. So, title is one of the most important thing that a report writer must take care of. The next thing is the writer's name, that who has written the report is the second part of the format. The third important thing is place, where the report has or where the event has taken place or where it has happened, where the event took place and the time of the event. That is an important part of it. Where the event took place and time of the event. The next important thing is body of the report, that is the content that you are going to put inside the body of the report. As an important thing, it could be of different paras. So para wise we are going to arrange it. What does these paras contain? At least there should be three or so paragraphs inside your report. So let's see what are the importance of these three different paragraphs. Para-wise, if we talk about the body of the report, paragraph 1 should be discussing or having the information as a short summary of the main happenings of the event. It should contain the main points. The second paragraph should have more details and elaboration or in-depth of the event that you have just mentioned in the first paragraph. That is more details along with some interesting information. More details, or I would say narration और इलेबोरेशन ऑफ द मेन इवेंट्स विथ इंटरेस्टिंग इंफॉर्मेशन. Interesting information. So this is the important point or the important thing that second paragraph should contain in a report writing. The third thing or the third paragraph should contain concluding remarks or concluding remarks or the end of the event as just discussed earlier. I can say the closing lines, yes, which will bring the event to an end, the report to an end. Finally, what was the outcome of the whole report that you are giving? Now let us take a sample report and try to write it in the format that we have just understood. So let me discuss with you. Say you are Sudeep, as given to us, as a member of the NCC group and group of your school. Write a report for your school magazine on a recently organized rock climbing training camp for NCC members of your town or city. Well, this is the heading given to us or the instruction given to us to write a sample report. Well, to write this, we'll first of all write the title, which is very important, and then the writer's name, followed by the place, and then followed by the body containing the three different paragraphs. So let us begin writing a sample report.
As you see, the picture displayed on your screen is of a sample report writing. Let us now read and analyze the given sample report. Just as we understood in the format that the first thing that you need to write is the title. So you can very well see the title being relevantly written over here, with connection to the instruction given to us about the rock climbing organized by the group for the NCC members. So as you see, the name being displayed right in the center over here, rock climbing camp for NCC members. Well, that is the right position or the place to write the title for a given report. It should be written probably in bold letters or first letters capitalized for each word except for the preposition used in it, followed by the next thing, that is the person who is reporting, the writer's name as given to us in the format. So here, who is reporting? It is Sudeep, who is one of the members of the NCC group, is reporting this to us. So on the left side or the left corner, you can see over there, beginning from the left side, you will find the name Sudeep, followed by his designation, who he is. He is the member of the NCC. You can see how, in what manner it is written: member, comma, NCC. NCC stands for National Cadet Corps. In the next line, you will see the place, followed by the date, Kendriya School, Uttarakhand, and then the date, July 8th, 2015. Well, the date can be written in the other way around also, with the date first, then the month, and then the year. but in that case we will not be using the comma. Well, the common and the formal way of writing the date is to write the month first, followed by the date using a separating comma, followed by the year. Therefore, July 8th, 2015 would be the way to write the date. Next is the first paragraph that we understood in the format, which should contain the short summary of the main happening of the event. So, well, what is the main happening of the event over here, which is the rock climbing camp arranged for the NCC members. So we need to provide the information about the same. So let us read the first paragraph. A rock climbing camp was organized by the NCC with the help of the Mountain Climbing Association Uttarakhand. Well, the rock climbing camp has come over here to perform the rock climbing activity, but they need to have arrangement done by the local association over here. Therefore, the MCA or the Mountain Climbing Association MCA has made arrangement, which is located in Uttarakhand, has made arrangement for the NCC cadets who have come from Meerut. Well, a total of 200 students from various Kendriya schools in Meerut attended the camp held on the 5th and 6th July. So it's written 5-6 July, referring to the two dates, organized for two different days, 5-6 July at Dhanolti near Mussoorie. So Dhanolti becomes the base camp near Mussoorie, which is a hill station. So the first paragraph is giving us the main idea of the whole event, which has been reported by Sudeep. Well, moving ahead with the next paragraph, which should have more details along with some interesting information. The same has been written or mentioned in this paragraph. Let us read it and understand how it suits to our format. The cadets were trained in rock climbing on natural rock formations by experienced and skilled rock climbers from the MCA, that is Mountain Climbing Association. So the Mountain Climbing Association people guided the NCC members who had participated over here in order to perform the rock climbing activity. So the cadets were trained on natural rock formations by experienced people. So this becomes the detailed information about the activity that took place in the report. Well, reading further, harnesses means straps or belts, ropes and other special equipment was provided by the MCA. So the MCA provided the required objects or the required equipment, without which it was not possible for them to perform the adventurous sport. So this also has been mentioned in the paragraph. Harnesses, ropes and other special equipment was provided by the MCA. Throughout the 2 days, groups of boys and girls could be seen attempting to climb up various rock formations around the camp. Well, this is also one of the important details that need to be provided in the second paragraph. The last line of the second paragraph: by evening of 6th July, almost all cadets had successfully managed at least one climb. So it happens sometimes that students are unable to do the climbing, but here almost everybody was successful in climbing at least one formation. So in this manner, the second paragraph provided the detailed information about the event, which was reported by Sudeep, that what happened. Well, moving ahead with the concluding part, that is the conclusion what we need to give. A certificate of participation was given to each cadet at the end of the 2 day camp. Have a look at the word 2 day written with the hyphen. We're not saying 2 days, but 2 day, that is two of the days. So a certificate of participation was provided to each candidate becomes an important part of the concluding paragraph, which we need to inform or which we need to report that after such a lot of hard work, were their efforts appreciated? So yes, it was appreciated by the participation certificate given to each candidate. Then how did the event come to an end? So for that, we need to write the concluding words over here in the passage. A vote of thanks was proposed by the NCC team leader to the members of the MCA. Well, it was the efforts of the MCA, the Mountain Climbing Association, who had managed the entire event to become a success. Therefore, they were thankful to them. So like this, we need to provide some information in this last concluding paragraph. The NCC cadets gave a rousing cheer to all their seniors and the members of the MCA who had ensured that the camp was a resounding success. So you see, the last line is so emphatic, so important, so choosy with words. The NCC cadets gave a rousing cheer. So everybody cheered and gave loud cheers, or just we can say appreciated the efforts of the MCA and the senior members, to all the senior members. And the last words again, you say, who had ensured that the camp was a resounding success. Have a look at the word resounding carefully. Resounding could have been replaced with just one simple word, great success. So you should be able to select choosy words which are very, very emphatic and has relevance to the topic that you are reporting about.
Now, after having discussed the sample report about the rock climbing camp for the NCC members, let us take a short report writing which is to be written in about 80 words on the problems caused by heavy rainfall in the city. So it has already rained in the city and we are making a report, a short report in about 80 words. Look at the points which will help you to write a report. Heavy rainfall obviously would be the main attraction as discussed in the format. We need to bring up the main points in the first paragraph. So heavy rainfall is the most important thing that must be highlighted. Well, the after problems when there is a heavy rainfall, which is very common, is waterlogging. Water gets stagnant in most of the places where there are no proper drainage systems. So one can report about that as well, showing the negligences and the non-performance of the municipal authorities. Water in homes, well, sometimes in the low-lying areas, water gets inside the dwellings or places. People move to safer places in order to save their lives. Traffic gets disrupted, very common problem, which is a part of heavy rainfall. Eventually, schools and colleges need to be shut down, so they are closed. Spread of disease. After rainfall, usually there is spread of diseases because there is a lot of mosquito breeding and other problems. Thereby, the hospitals get alerted because they know about it, that there could be cases of fever, cold, cough and other things when people get wet in such heavy rains. Apart from that, sometimes the rains that have slashed the place could have even more rainfall in the coming time. Therefore, meteorological department, that is the weather forecasting department, forecasts heavy rains in the next 48 hours. These could be some points that you could include in your report writing to make it very, very interesting. Let me read out the entire report to you. I have just started a few important things over here. When you start writing, we require the first important thing is title. Therefore, heavy rains forecasted in the next 48 hours, I have chosen as my title. You could have a title for yourself. What is suitable? It should be short and very, very attractive. Reporter, I've taken the name as imaginary thing, Sarika Sharma. You could have a name for yourself, whatever you feel proper can write. Ahmedabad, well, a very big city where we usually find a good lot of rain coming. So Ahmedabad, June 25th, 2020. The heavy rainfall, and then I would read out to you. The heavy rainfall for the past 3 days has disrupted normal life. So you see, I am reporting this on the 25th today. Well, rains have already taken place 3 days ago. So for the last 3 days, there has been heavy rainfall. The heavy rainfall for the past 3 days has disrupted normal life. See, the first important thing that I have read over here in the first paragraph. In the city, there is water logging in the low-lying areas of the city. Another important point to be included, as you can see in the points section. Rainwaters have flooded the homes of people. A very important problem that low-lying area people living over there face. forcing the people to leave their homes and belongings and move to safer areas. Who would like to leave their belongings and their comfort zone and go to another place which is unknown to them? But still, in order to save their lives, they have to leave. So that is something, that important thing that you are mentioning in the first paragraph. Well, it is not necessary. You could have just one simple paragraph, two, or perhaps two, but three is an important thing. Traffic in the city has come to stand still. Due to congestion of traffic, you find that life comes to a standstill. People are honking, there is a lot of noise pollution going on, people are in a hurry to go wherever, to the destinations wherever they want to reach. So there is a lot of chaos taking place, or traffic chaos is observed or experienced. Many vehicles were seen stuck in the waterlogged areas. Many times your vehicle doesn't start, or it gets stopped over there, no matter how much you try, because water is entered into its compartments or chambers. Well, schools and colleges have declared a week's holiday. Sometimes it is a very unusual situation. Sometimes it's completely a situation which is out of control. So schools have to declare holidays, perhaps at least for a day or two. And sometimes it is a situation is very, very severe, and for a week or so. Well, it happens. Fearing the spread of diseases, authorities, that's the municipal authorities of that place, say Ahmedabad authorities, the AMC, have kept the hospitals across the city on high alert. They are completely warned that there could be cases where people might have caught diseases. And in addition to that, the meteorological department giving its forecast that although there were three days of rain slashing and the water getting logged, still for the next 48 hours, two more days, there could be heavy rainfalls, in order to alert the people, alert the public living over there, the population living over there, so that they can stay safe in their homes. So the meteorological department has forecasted heavy rainfall for the next 48 hours. These could be some points with even more elaboration to it when you write the report in this manner. Well, finally, you can conclude with the lines, people are advised to stay at home and do not come out of their house unnecessarily, and try to keep necessary edible commodities required for their needs at home. Well, this was about the report writing, a sample writing that we just saw. Let us take one more example of a similar type. Now let's discuss yet another question about report writing . As you see, things mentioned over here, write a short report in about 80 words on how the Republic Day was celebrated in your school. Points that will be useful in order to write the report. Let's read them out. Great joy. Yes, obviously, Republic Day is a matter of joy. It's a national festival, so all Indians rejoice. Playground, usually when it is conducted in school, it's conducted on a playground. Things are set up over there. So an important word, keyword, decorated, we make a lot of decoration. Chief guest is one must who is going to hoist the flag. And the following word, as you see, flag hoisting, the most important part of Republic Day. National anthem is also equally important. Then variety entertainment program, which we look forward to. Speech of, say, student. Speech could be of the chief guest. Speech could be given by the principal. It could be a volunteer or the captain. So we have got maybe one or more than one speeches. Finally, vote of thanks, which brings the program to a conclusion, to the end. So these are just the keywords that you see over here, and we'll be reading out the entire thing. Republic Day celebrations is the title that I have chosen for my report writing. You can choose a similar one of your choice, which could be even more attractive than this. So here the reporter is Samiksha, taken in my opinion. Samiksha is making a report writing about the Republic Day celebrations School name, Gyanmanjari Vidyapeeth. As explained earlier, we require a place where the celebration was conducted with relevant time and date. So, 27 January 2020, this is the most formal way of writing a date when reporting an event. To begin, we have the Republic Day function was celebrated with great joy. So you see, the word great joy has been included because it is a matter of joy. You can even elaborate this with other adjectives if you feel proper. Great joy and fervor. Fervor is again what? All kind of pamperings that were done in the entire celebration. So fervor. The playground, the second point, as you see elaborated, the playground was decorated with colorful balloons and ribbons. So yes, it is decorated in order to express the happiness and joy of celebrating the Republic Day. Next, we took the point into consideration was the chief guest. So chief guest has been mentioned. Shri Nakrani sir, the founder trustee, was the chief guest. So you are mentioning who the exact person was as the chief guest, which is an important part of report writing. The function began. Now you're giving the description, how it started, when did it start. The function began with the flag hoisting. Obviously, that is the first and foremost event in a Republic Day. And after that, the other activities take place. And the national anthem, naturally, it's followed by that. Then the students presented a variety of entertainment programs, which is always the attraction of the event. And here we are highlighting or writing in our report. Well, this is just one sentence. Then the students represented a variety of entertainment program. You could still elaborate this in if the report writing was more than 80 words, say 120 words or even more than that. Then you mentioned some of those events that were conducted with all the details about it, the kind of programs that were presented. There were patriotic songs, dances, drills, skits. So just a brief idea of what were the variety programs have been given in the next sentence. Well, this could be elaborated if required. Then the chief guest addressed the audience. The audience who were there, who were witnessing the program, those who were listening over there, so we can say the audience. The chief guest addressed the audience. His speech, then we are further giving an understanding what the speech was. His speech inspired the feeling of love and brotherhood. So it was a kind of speech given which could evolve or which could give a boost to these two patriotic feelings in the country. The function finally ended with a vote of thanks by the principal. So you see, we have just written a report writing with very few words, say 80 words, what was given to us with a limit. So this is the manner how you can write it. This is the second one that we saw. We will see yet another one. Now let's discuss the next report writing. As you see on the board, the instruction given to you, the Red Cross Society has organized a blood donation camp in TCS, which refers to the Tata Consultancy Services, at Gandhinagar for its employees. You've been asked to write a report of about 200 words. We just had the previous one in around 180 words, similar to that one, covering the event of a reporter of the Times of India. You are supposed to write a report. Well, I have taken an imaginary name over here. You can keep your name as a reporter of Times of India for yourself. Well, let's discuss the important parts of it. As discussed in the format, we require a suitable title, an eye-catchy or a title that brings interest. Well, when it's about blood donation, so naturally it should be pertaining or related to blood donation camp. So, blood donation camp at TCS, a simple title. Title should not be that it becomes very unviable or something. It should be to the content. So, blood donation camp at TCS. The reporter, Payal, as I have just imaginated a person, Where did it happen? We require the place, which is very important. So it took place at Gandhinagar as mentioned in the instruction given to us. Date is also very important. 14th March 2020, that is the day when you are reporting the event. It did not happen on 14th March. Keep this in mind. A report writing is a report which you are doing after the event has taken place. So 14th March is the date of the report. Well, it happened earlier, so our language would be in the past tense. We don't use the first person in the report writing as the pronouns I or me. We do not write that. Perhaps we make use of, or we try to make use of, the third person. To start with the main part or the main content, or to write the main points which will cover the first paragraph as explained in the format. A blood donation camp was organized by Red Cross Society on 10th March 2020. So, when did it take place? On 10th March, 4 days before the report was, or before the event was reported. From 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. So, the timing is also very important to be mentioned. 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. Till that time, it was given for the employees to come and donate their blood. At TCS Gandhinagar. Now, this is just one important point or the starting of this report. What is the entire thing about? The main purpose of this event was, why was this created? Why was the need? Naturally, they could do it by themselves also if they wished, if they wanted to do it. Well, the main purpose of this event was to create awareness regarding regular blood donation among the employees so that the company could create or instill the habit of donating blood in the employees to make them learn the awareness. It was a very well-planned camp and many employees voluntarily participated in this noble cause. Well, donating blood is a noble cause. It is donated for, we very well know, at the times of emergencies so that people can get it. So it's a noble cause. So this is an important word to be used in such a report writing. So make choicest words when you write the first paragraph. It should be very, very impressive. The next, which is the elaboration or the understanding of what you have just mentioned. This is just you introduced your topic about the report writing. What is it about? Now you are giving the in-depth details of the report writing. What all happened? A team of 5 doctors and 20 nurses were present at the location. Naturally, without doctors and nurses, it wouldn't have been possible. You require specialists or you require people of the field who can extract your blood from the body. Naturally, you can't do it by yourself. It was a joke. A team of 5 doctors and 20 nurses were present at the location. And naturally, somebody has to make a beginning in order to give a boost. So, Dr. Akash gave an informative speech on the importance of blood donation. But before the blood donation started, before somebody could start giving the blood, it was important to take information about the importance of giving blood or donating blood. Therefore, the doctor who had come over there gave an informative speech as to what are the benefits of blood donation and how would it help them and what kind of benefits they would be getting in case they require blood in emergency situations. Therefore, Dr. Akash gave informative speech on the importance of blood donation at the start of the event. And that is how the event started. The first person to donate the blood was the head of the HR department, the human resource development. Because it's a consultancy firm, TCS, naturally they would be having an HR department. So the head of the department was the first person so that he could inspire the others and push or bring a kind of a thrust in the other employees, even to the ones who were reluctant, because blood donating is a kind of voluntary thing. You don't force somebody to do it, isn't it? But you inspire people. Therefore, the head of the department did it in the first place, or he was the first one. After that, a large number of employees donated blood. See, how did they donate? With beaming faces, bright gleaming and bright faces without any kind of hesitation. And a proud heart. So they also felt proud that they are doing or they are donating blood for a noble cause. Maybe somebody who is in need will be utilizing their blood and they will be able to save somebody's life. So it's a life-giving experience to all these employees. Well, that is one thing. Further, what happened as the part of the event whole thing? We are writing into it. Refreshment was provided before and after the donation of the blood to each donor. So each donor was given refreshments to eat. Also, for the satisfaction, for each donor to be satisfied that they have done a noble cause, a certificate of appreciation, because it's a matter of appreciation. When you donate blood, it's a matter of appreciation. You are felicitated for that. So, a certificate of appreciation along with donor card. A card is given to the donor which mentions the date, time and the unit of blood that he has donated as a matter of record. And a tea mug as a matter of gesture of gratitude were given to each donor as a token of gratitude. So, each of them were felicitated with certificate, donor card and a tea mug. Well, this was the second paragraph giving us the elaborated information about the blood donation. Let us see the concluding part or the concluding passage, concluding lines of this. Now, let's read and understand the concluding paragraph of the report writing. As the end of the event was approaching, there was a sense of satisfaction on the faces of volunteers as a total of 257 units of blood was collected. So, this could be the closing lines of a report where you can give a summary or a summarization of what the event was about or what was the success rate of the event. So, in the report or in the end of the report, you will be writing in the last paragraph something related to the event in a closing manner. So, you see here 257 units as a part of collection of blood is reported. Finally, the team of doctors appreciated all those who participated in the camp and made it a huge success. So this was the last paragraph or the closing lines or the closing paragraph of the report writing. Hence, three parts of the report writing were done. Now let us see yet another example of report writing as given to you on the board. The instructions given to us are: a Spanish national was robbed by an unknown biker. Write a news report in about 80 words. So, a very simple topic given to us: a foreigner or national, a Spanish national, was robbed by unknown people, unknown bikers, and we have to make a report about it around 80 words. So, just like what we did in the previous report writing, we will be continuing the pattern and understanding. First, the most important thing is a catchy title. So, bikers snatch a bag from a Spanish man. So, I think so this should be quite attractive for someone to read in a newspaper article. Then, we need to write the name of the reporter. So, I have imagined a name, by Rashmi. Now, you see the difference? I have used the word by. So, alternatively, we can write the word by along with the name of the person, unlike what we did in the previous sample report. By Rashmi, followed by the place where the incident took place, New Delhi, the date, which is also very important, 15th May 2020, and then the required three parts, of which the first one will give us the main idea of the report. Well, so a very small passage: a Spanish national was robbed of his belongings. Actually, that is what we want to report, that a foreigner was robbed and the foreigner was a Spanish national as given to us in the instruction. Spanish was robbed of his belongings by some unidentified bike-borne men while he was traveling in a rickshaw. So you see the word used over here, unidentified. So we don't know who the person was. Therefore, I have just changed the word alternatively unknown to unidentified. That suits better. So we need to use the most appropriate and words which are synonyms of the word given to us, that is appropriated. So some unidentified bike borne. So bike borne means on the bike would be referred to as bike borne. Okay. Bike borne men while he was traveling in a rickshaw. While the Spanish man was traveling in a rickshaw. Now in the second para or second passage, you will be giving the details about actually what happened. This was just the first passage in which we introduced our topic. Well, Bonchart Smith, there comes the name of the Spanish man. Bonchart Smith, who hails from, hails means who belongs to, hails means who belongs to or belonging to a particular place, comes from. Bonchart Smith, who hails from Barcelona, was traveling with his friend Mukesh Jha. So he was not traveling alone, he was traveling with one of his friend because he was a foreign national. So maybe he had some friend over here. So we are informing that also, that somebody else is also the witness. Witness is very important in a theft or a robbery to derive or to get to the roots of the cause and to the criminal, so that somebody can witness that the incident happened. So he was traveling with his friend Mukesh Jha, where from Connaught Place to Pahadganj. So that needs to be given in the report when you go and lodge a complaint. From Connaught Place to Pahadganj, when the incident took place at 8:30 p.m. So this is what we are doing in the second passage. We are giving the minutest details of the incident that is being reported. On Monday, a serious police officer said. So all this was said by a senior police officer. On Monday, by a senior police officer said. Now this was said by a senior police officer. This is the third such incident. Now starts our third passage, where we are giving the other important things and moving towards the conclusion of the report. This is the third such incident in the last 7 days. Something connected to that. See, this was the main incident, but this is something related to that incident. This has happened even earlier. And how long back it happened? Just in the last 7 days. This is the third such incident in the last 7 days where a foreigner has been targeted. This is not the first incident taking place in Delhi like this. This is the seventh thing happening in the last 7 days. This is the third time happening. Smith said two bike-borne youths came from behind and snatched his bag, because we need the statement of the victim. So here the victim, who is Bonchart Smith, is giving statement to the police, the senior police officer, who is telling to the news reporter. So Smith said that two bike-borne people on the bike, who were youth, they were young. So the identification is also very important. How did they look like? They came from behind and snatched his bag. But further he says, he claimed to have lost his passport, mobile and 1,000 euros. He must be carrying an international currency. So he's saying he lost all these articles that was inside the bag that was snatched by the robbers. He said, and the exact words spoken by Bonchart Smith, I could not see their faces because they were wearing helmets. The police have registered an FIR. FIR refers to First Information Report. I hope everyone knows the full form of this abbreviation. And are investigating the case. But no arrests have been made so far. So you see, we have written a report writing in three parts over here, where the first part was the introduction to our topic. Second was the minutest details, and finally the third one was the in-depth plus the conclusion, which we reached to the end of the report writing. Hope this has helped you.
Well, it is now time to note down the homework. So have a look at your screen. The image being displayed shows the homework for today. Take a screenshot of the same and do the homework. Prepare a PDF of the same and submit it after the lecture. This is all for today's lecture. See you soon in the upcoming lecture. Till then, take care. Have a nice day and goodbye.